Hi, and welcome back to our open stop-motion film project. As usually, I had to restart and do stuff to get all the mics on. I don't know why that has to be such a problem, but it is. Every time. It's Wirecast that's shutting them down, and then I have to restart everything to get them on again. So I cannot figure out why that is, but it is. But now we up and driving. So. And we will keep on. I'll make some textures on this tree, and go on from there. So we can. We got the little bigger one finished yesterday, and now I will do this one. And I apologize for yesterday. I was very tired, but. I have gotten some sleep and much better now. So I will just see. And I have just uploaded the kids workshop from yesterday. So. It's up on Pixelfantasies.com, where my granddaughter Ida and I are making a dollhouse, or more a doll castle. But I had to edit it a little because there was a lot of interruption, because a six-year-old girl cannot have attention span that long. So I will get some clay. She's all over the place. She wants some paint, and she wants to have something to eat, and then we have a toilet visit and whatnot, you know. But it's really nice to have a little granddaughter to be together with, so don't matter. We have to take it as it comes. And I do. Get so I can see the chat. If someone gets in here, and we will take. And so now we can keep an eye on things. And these, it's hard to see the textures on the stream, but I even overdo them a little because I as I told before, a lot of it get lost in the print and the scanning, so it is hard to overdo because they are barely visible afterwards, but it gives a little texture so it don't look plastic like. We don't like plastic trees. Or plastic looking trees. No problem with plastic, but we don't. That's one of the what I like about stop motion is there is a kind of edge to everything. Gives a little different feelings apart from computer generated animations. I love those too, but this is kind of another kind, have its own advantage. can be very hard to see. On this yellow clay here. Or oil-based clay as a whole. Because it's a little bit shining in the light, so when you see it from one angle, it's you think you have taken all the floors, but when you then turn it around a little, then you see a lot of floors. So. That's kind of a drawback with this, but sooner or later I will get all the kinks straightened out, I guess, hope. So. Down on the floor. What can we do? Yes, we can. And tomorrow, my grandson Frederick comes visit, and but he's 9 years old, so he have only one thing in his head, like every other 9 year old boy: Minecraft. Game. He loves it. And then he have his sorry, his uncle to play with, my youngest son. So, and that his love, that's he loves. I get him right after the school is finished, and then the first thing he asks is if his uncle have time to play today. I'm afraid I'm not too much help because I never play. And have never done it, so. But I understand why they love it. He got an Xbox to his birthday. And that's really smart. What he can do with that. Kind of freestyling. This. This is going down. Okay. Stop it. It must be too little coffee. The only explanation that can be. So, whoopsie. Damn it. One thing that irritates me, that is, as always, a lot of stuff going on in the background, and you can never see what it is. I know you look in the task manager, no, because as soon as you start then, that one, nothing going on, but there is. All the time. Yesterday it was never over maybe 82% in CPU and no memory used. It could handle all of it in the CPU and today it's 65% memory and 82% CPU. So oops, now I know why. It's my fault. Oops. Now we're down again. It was when you have, you can see over there, when these thumbnail is live. Then you have problems. Then they take a lot of. See, now it's running smooth. So sorry, I accused a wrong one. But sometimes that is like I. It is like I said. Stuff going on. Maybe someone is making bitcoins with the free computer cycles. One never know. If they are mining a little, in the background, I'm sure they will share it with me if they do. For sure they will. some of it. I need to have like this. You always have to remember when you print, it does it in slice. So if anything hangs under, then if this was bent down out here, then it start to print here, and then it start to print out here in the air. So it cannot, it has to, but when it's like this, then there is something to print on all the time. So that you have to have in your thoughts when you model stuff. See, here you will have a problem, because it prints to here, and then it start to print a little out here. So you need to bend this a little, so it goes up all the time, all the way up. Nothing can hang under the last slice, and you will get a bad print. But yesterday I saw something about, or was it the day before, I saw something about fluid print. Very fast method they have figured out, where they kind of draw it up out of a bath, and it's really fast. But they have only a prototype yet, so it will be fun to see how much they were gonna, what the price will be. My printer board was $1,200. So I think I have a printer board plus. But PrinterBot have made a bigger one, so I can print a bigger object. Than the reason I wanted the Plus model was it could print big, but the biggest of those there were. That were at the time. and I have been happy with it. I think it will be a while before everyone have one of those in their home. I think in the start they kind of oversold the idea a little, so that people thought that they could print their own Lego bricks and so on, and that is not gonna happen. It's fantastic for what I'm using it for. But I don't, it's not that easy to get it working as people think, maybe think. It's hard to get a, what? It's a little difficult to get a good scan, and it's a little difficult to get a good print when you want it to be very precise and so on. It's not a tool for everybody, I think. This, it is fantastic. And that's one of the things I love about the printerbot people. They didn't let you believe that it was that easy, that you could print a new big set of Lego to Christmas, to your children. I have heard several of the other guys talking like it was just load the scan and push the button and then come back later and take the stuff out. And that's not the case. I have printed many hundred hours on mine, and I have at times been very frustrated because I couldn't get it to work like I wanted to. And you shouldn't think that it was that difficult, because it's really simple. Kind of a glue gun, putting on layers by layers by layers. How hard could that be? But there are hundreds and hundreds of adjustments you can make in the software. And most of them I even don't understand yet. There is an unlimited numbers of possibilities I have to leave you a second. There's not much room in here. Brr. I hope in the weekend I can get a lot of these scanned so I can get printing. I have tons of stuff I need to get printed. There is so much stuff all the time to do. need to do. The list is very long. And who would have dreamt that tomorrow we have our episode number 100? That is crazy. Time goes past, too fast. But we will wait with celebrating until the movie is finished. No reason to do it before that. Uh-huh. You get all these, when you make the textures, you get all these small crumbs in, on the surface of it. And we will not have them. All over the place. like there's fur on it. We don't want to have fur on our trees. So Okay. Very soon we can have the door open to the balcony and hear the birds in the evening. That is always a treat. It's a little too cold yet. And there is not many birds. Besides of the doves and a couple of yaks. Those are not the singing kinds. And my friend, the swallows. I'm not arrived yet either, and I haven't heard the starlings, but very soon they will come.
Lips.
Be careful. So I think we have been everywhere now. Oop. Too much, too big, too much, too little. I think we are finished and ready for scan when we get this. I'm not gonna work. But now it is. Oopsie. It's so easy to miss this spot. So easy. But I will adjust it just before I take the pictures for scanning. Finish with that, and now we'll go and get a new one so we can finish that also. Thank you. have a little smoothing out to do on this one, and then we have some problems with these. And this one is really awful. Some problems with this. I think we have to straighten this out a little, because otherwise it wouldn't work. Not everything goes according to plan. Sometimes you have to do it all again. Okay, then we do so. Step forwards and one step backwards. That is some kind of progress. Anyway, so church built. Like the Catholics have their evening service, I think. Much better than before. But now we have to get it up again. I think we will let it rest a little on that side. I have not been careful enough to straighten these out, so they kind of go through the clay. Okay, we do it the hard way. I will not have them that thick, these branches. So we will straighten them now out a little. So then we can take this while we are at it, because you will run into the same problem here. Sooner or later. Thank you. I should have done this before. I put clay on it. That was not very smart. But now we know. And then we do like this, because it kind of loosened when we but we will get it fixed. So, and then I do like so. This. We can start all over. And hopefully succeed. I have to take on a little trip. So, finally, now we twist One of the things that's difficult about making a tree like this is that us people want to make things symmetric, and a young tree is very symmetric, but old fellow like this. It's very asymmetric. So it's a little difficult because your eye keeps looking for symmetry. And there has to be symmetry some places, but not. Because of the way things grow and so on, but this tree is also starting to kind of decay, kind of. Old age. We often think that how we are perceiving things, different things, is very individual to each human, but it actually is not when it comes to shapes. And most people, when they make tests, most people consider those that are most symmetric as the most beautiful. Or if you ask people who are the most beautiful people, and give them some samples, and then afterwards it shows that it is those who are most symmetric. Oops. So we are not all that unique that we often think we are. Good at putting my fingernails into everything. Wait a little with that one. I'll get a little cold again. Or cool down, or what we shall say. Wouldn't it be fun if I had 25 or so people? people sitting here and doing. Kind of the same stuff, making trees and figures and cast and molds and that would be crazy fun. Instead of me sitting here alone doing it. I envy those people on Pixar and Leica and whatnot, where there are whole crew doing stuff. But this is how it is. It would be nice. I would love it. Oh, it's really soft. Give it a little rest. Stop fumbling with it. It's too soft. Right now. Close. Then I'm jumping all over the place. Take some oil in here. Removed it from my granddaughter, not. There's a little guy here who wants to we have insect in the forest. Now he will not let go of my stick. He have gotten something he don't like because he's flying around with upside down. That's not good. Something wrong? Poor little guy.
Thank you.
And then you sit and be so careful with the details, and maybe you'll never see it from that side, or so that's the fun part of it. Every detail is okay, then I can shoot from what angle I want to. So we have to do it. It wouldn't be good if we made it like, oops, no, we cannot shoot it from here. It's look bad because of bad details.
Sorry.
is one drawback with this copper stuff here. That is that the clay kind of glues to it. It's difficult to get off. A piece of paper can do it. Because these here, it don't glue to. Why, I don't know. And then if I would quit putting my fingernails into it, that would be a good thing. Oopsie. Ow. kind of get in the zone sometimes. And forget stuff around you. And it is these small details. But there is some stuff left. Some stuff left before we can get to the Oscars. Have to change the rules in the Oscars so that it goes to towns where people live in, because I'm pretty much sure that I'm the only one in this town, and it's a small town that makes what I do, so we should have a chance. And the best animated film from Svendborg goes to, see that one. But I don't think that will change the way they do it. Have to settle for the fun we have making it, but that is good enough. Boom. Fingers in it. But are we not coming to the end of tonight? I think we are. I think I will close for tonight and start uploading this video here and make ready for tomorrow. We have quick kids workshop tomorrow, and of course tomorrow night we have this episode number 100, because this is number 99. So I will say thank you for tonight, and hope I'll see you again tomorrow, episode number 100. Thank you and good night from here.